through the season of Advent, please join us in beginning our worship services with prayer and contemplation, observing the incense that thickens the air, reminding us that the Holy Spirit is with us. Observe the lit candles on the Advent wreath. Help us mark time as we anticipate Christ's new birth in our hearts and our lives. Join in the singing of the Tese refrain that calls our attention to the ongoing need for justice and peace for all God's children.
The second Advent candle reminds us of Jesus' life-giving peace to all who trust in him. As the light of the Advent candles brighten, may our peace and hope be strengthened in you, our Savior.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Merciful God, who sent your messengers, the prophets, to preach repentance and prepare the way for our salvation, give us grace to heed their warnings and forsake our sins, that we may greet with joy the coming of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together. And the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice cries, cry out, and I say, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades. When the breath of the Lord blows upon it, surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the people.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read Psalm 85 in unison. You have been gracious to your land, O Lord. You have restored the good fortune of Jacob. You have forgiven the iniquity of your people and blotted out all their sins. I will listen to what the Lord God is saying, for he is speaking peace to his faithful people and to those who turn their hearts to him. Truly, his salvation is very near to those who fear him, that his glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth have met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Truth shall spring up from the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. The Lord will indeed grant prosperity, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness shall go before him, and peace shall be a pathway for his feet.
A reading from the second letter of Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord, one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years are like one day. The Lord is not slow about his promise, as some think of slowness, but is patient with you, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a loud noise, and the elements will be dissolved with fire, and the earth and everything that is done on it will be disclosed. Since all these things are to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be in leading lives of holiness and godliness, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of our God, because of which the heavens will be set ablaze and dissolved, and the elements will melt with fire? But in accordance with his promise, we wait for new heavens and a new earth, where righteousness is at home. Therefore, beloved, while you are waiting for these things, strive to be found by him at peace, without spot or blemish, and regard the patience of the Lord as salvation. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the people.
Thanks be to God.
Come to thee, O Israel. didst give the law in cloud and majesty and awe. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark. The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight.' John the baptizer appeared in the wilderness proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole of the Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locust and wild honey. He proclaimed, 'The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit.'" The Gospel of the Lord. Prepare the way of the Lord. In the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. These are the prophetic words from Isaiah that are echoed in the Gospel of Mark. Prepare the way of the Lord. And just how do we do that? On this second Sunday of Advent, when we find ourselves in wildernesses of all sorts, how do we prepare the way of the Lord? In a season of uncertainty, fear, and loss, how do we prepare the way? If we listen closely to the words of our readings today, we are given clues about how we might prepare the way. Here's the list. Comfort God's people. Lift up your voice. Do not fear. Proclaim, "Here is your God." Lead lives of holiness and godliness. Wait and strive. Repent, confess your sins. Those are elements of preparing the way of the Lord. I would suggest the one on the list that is the least appealing to you is perhaps right where God is calling your attention. For example, if evangelism makes you uncomfortable, proclaiming, "Here is your God," is likely to make you squirm. If you, like me, are impatient for things to happen, the word "wait" might truly be a four-letter word to you. Let's inspect this list of activities that help us prepare the way. But first, let's explore the nature of the way. Just what is the way of the Lord? Some theologians say the way of the Lord is justice and compassion. Others say it is truth. Some say the way is love. So it seems we ought to be about truth, justice, compassion, and love as we prepare the way of the Lord. Comfort, oh, comfort my people, says your God. Most of us are involved in extending comfort to those in need. We offer a listening ear to a friend in pain, a bag of groceries to those who hunger, or a warm coat to one who is homeless. Maybe we restock books in a neighborhood little free library that comfort children and adults who are isolated in this time of disease. Perhaps you make phone calls or write notes to friends who are homebound and away from family and loved ones. Comforting those who are less comfortable than we are is not that hard to do. It just requires noticing and acting. How are you comforting God's people these days? Lift up your voice. It actually says, lift up your voice with strength. Lift it up. Do not fear. Say, here is your God. This verse reminds me of the words of Maggie Coon. You have likely heard her quoted, even if you don't recognize her name. Maggie Coon, a lay Presbyterian minister and social activist, is known for saying, speak the truth, even if your voice shakes. At the age of 65, Maggie Coon founded the Gray Panthers, a group of activists that fought for the rights of senior citizens. She wrote two books, You Can't Be Human Alone, and Get Out There and Do Something About Injustice. Through her activism and Christian service, Maggie proclaimed, here is your God, even if her voice was shaking. How do you let others know that God is with them, both in the good times and in the bad and very bad times? Next, we have lead lives of holiness and godliness. This does not mean spending all day kneeling in your closet praying, although prayer is likely a part of living a holy life. But living a holy life means getting your hands dirty doing what Jesus did. Jesus confronted injustices and condemned political powers that treated people poorly. Jesus loved outcasts and refugees and frequently dined with a bunch of sinners. That's what holiness and godliness looks like in preparing the way of the Lord. 2020 has certainly provided ample opportunity to wait and strive. We have been waiting in our homes much of the time, hoping to stay healthy and keep others healthy. We are waiting to get back to something that seems like normal in our world. We have waited for test results, waited for election results, and waited for a vaccine to be developed. We know something about waiting, whether we like it or not. We're encouraged to have our waiting marked with striving, an action, a verb defined as to make great efforts to achieve or obtain something, to struggle or fight vigorously. As we prepare the way of the Lord, we are to fight vigorously to be found at peace. Therefore, whatever interferes with the peace of your soul, with peace in your life, that is what you are to be fighting, struggling against, making an effort to change. So we don't just sit and wait. We are active in the waiting, doing work in our hearts and in our minds to be at peace in our souls. I had a transformative experience in March with this waiting and striving. I had a few regrets in my life that I just could not let go, and they impacted my peace. Some of them I had carried for years, others for a shorter while, but the weight of these regrets was burdensome. I wrote this list of regrets in my journal and made an appointment with a priest for prayer and confession. You know, this is a good idea for everyone, and I have plenty of open office hours should you feel so moved. For my yearly confession, I detailed each of the 5 regrets that I had written down. The priest listened. She encouraged me to do something to tangibly make a sign that I had laid these regrets at the feet of God and need not pick them up again. She prayed for me, blessed me, and sent me on my way. I set out for a hike immediately following, not sure how I would mark the occasion, until I came upon a rocky, desolate area. I found 5 rocks, stacked one on top of the other, naming those regrets as I made this visual reminder that those are left at the feet of God. It felt good to release those burdens. I continued further down the trail and came to a green, lush, life-filled area. Again, there were rocks. I made another pile of 5 rocks, naming the things that I want to replace the regrets, naming what I wanted to strive to keep as the foundation of my life. You likely recognize this whole process as repentance, confession of sins. It wasn't that my regrets were any particular sin, but the burden of the regrets had become a sin because they were interfering with my spiritual peace and wholeness. Whatever interferes with our relationship with God and our peace in God is sin. Preparing the way of the Lord means striving to lay those sins at the feet of God, repenting of the things that we let make us less than God dreams for us. We confess the ways we form habits, create resentments, live out our prejudices that disrupt our peace and interfere with our journey with God. From now through Christmas, won't you heed the prophetic call? Prepare the way. Prepare the way of the Lord by works of justice, acts of compassion, words of truth and love. Prepare the way of the Lord for others, and prepare that same way for yourself. Amen.
Let us affirm our faith together in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The prayers of the people. With all our heart and with all our mind, let us pray, saying, Christ, have mercy.
For the peace from above, for the loving kindness of God, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray. Christ have mercy. For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray. Christ have mercy. For Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, the presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church, Scott, our bishop, for all bishops, ministers, and lay leaders, let us pray. Christ have mercy. For Donald, our president, Joe, our president-elect, Greg, our governor, and Betsy, our mayor, for all who are in command in the military and for first responders, let us pray. Christ have mercy. For the good earth which God has given us and for the wisdom and will to conserve it, let us pray. Christ have mercy. For healthcare providers and support staff worldwide and the patients in their care, for the aged and infirm, for refugees and victims, for the sick and suffering, and for those we now name. Let us pray. Christ have mercy. for all who have died in the hope of resurrection, and for all the departed, let us pray. Christ, have mercy. For deliverance from all danger, violence, oppression, and degradation, let us pray. Christ, have mercy. In the communion of the Blessed Virgin Mary and of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to God.
To thee, Almighty God. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
A blessing for your journey this week. May the God of hope fill you. May the God of joy overflow you. May the God of peace pour you out into the world. May God Almighty, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier, bless and keep you now and forever. Amen. Go in peace, seeking justice for all God's children.
Thanks be to God.